All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome on back here at Valor Fitness in Seminole, Florida, right outside St. Pete. We got a break in the Florida Grid League action. So, for your entertainment, we got the kids' grid breaking it out. You got Team Fire in the red right on your screen. Team Storm in the blue. These kids today are performing the same exact races you see on the grid when the big boys and big girls come out to play. Right now, working on partner forward. Storm in the blue on your screen right now. Again, these kids are training just as hard as some of these grid athletes do. And they're running the same exact races. You've got Coach Jess Crisman there. And you see some of our Florida Grid League players on the floor right now, helping coach, helping ref. It's great to see that during these breaks between the matches. Both of these teams working on snatches and box jump overs. Training the future of the FGL. You'll see these kids on the grid floor for about 10 years, 15 years, who knows? We're teaching them young, starting them young. That fire team knocking out those box jump overs. Now on to the snatches. Here goes the Storm. Storm knocking out those snatches with ease. Now, if you're watching at home, stay tuned after the kids' match at 5 o'clock. You have match number 3 of this quadruple header today here at Valor Fitness as the Sharks take on the Aces as a Fire cross that finish line first and take the first race here on Kids Grid. Storm right behind them. We're going to go ahead and reset this floor and get these kids ready for their next race.
The whole place was erupting. It was incredible.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's so exciting.
Yeah. The adrenaline is so much. I felt the crowd, it like got me up.
You're racing and you're screaming and you want them to win, your blood pressure goes like all the way up.
their next race is Mir. They're doing 10 thrusters in East Quadrant. 45 pounds for the ladies, 65 for the gentlemen. All right, here we go, 10 seconds.
And we're back to some action here on the grid floor. Kids Grid back to work.
10 thrusters in each project. 45 pounds and 65 pounds.
So now these kids, it's their turn to take on the mirror race. A total of 28 thrusters. 7 for each gender in each quadrant. So we're going to work our way all the way down to quadrant number 4. 7 reps in each quad.
Kids Grid, we don't have that female bars. Everybody does look at everything.
You got the fire in the red, storm in the blue right now on your screen. You got that head coach, Jess Crisman, for the Storm in blue. You'll see here later on tonight at 7 p.m. as she stars on the Tampa Bay Brigade, who take on the Orlando Aces right now. Excuse me. They took on the Orlando Aces earlier. They'll take on the Gainesville Wild later on. You see her again on that screen as Team Storm working hard on this mirror race. Team Storm working hard on their thrusters. Team Storm onto that last quadrant. Here is Team Fire as well. We are neck and neck in this kids' grid. Team Storm in the blue, they are working fast, they are working hard. Final few reps. It's gonna come down to the wire. And Team Storm crosses the finish line first. We are all tied up, one race apiece between Team Storm and Team Fire. Let's see what we got coming up next here on Kids Grid.
only get to try out on the warm-up or on the grid. Like, you don't normally touch that other than a tire. So very foreign, but it's gonna be good. Being a professional strongman, we lift heavy objects all the time, so it's right in my wheelhouse.
Come on. It feels good. It's better than having a big tire. I like it. Good handling.
This is my first time using it. I'm pretty excited. I've done tire flips to try to make it pretty similar in the past. My deadlift is really strong, so that's the main reason why I'm not concerned about it.
I kind of have a football background, so being that, tire flips and all that, it brings me back to those days, so I like it. It's one of my favorite movements out here.
Hi guys, my name is Paula, and today I'm gonna teach you how to perform freestanding handstand push-ups. The freestanding handstand push-up is essentially starting in a tripod, extending arms to lock out in a brief handstand, and then ideally returning to the tripod to be in position to begin the next rep. I recommend having proficiency in a strict and keeping handstand push-ups against the wall as well.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. The kids back on the grid floor. This time they take on the ladder. They've taken on partner forward. They've taken on mirror. Now they get to show off their strength. That is right. Ladder coming up. 1 point for each respective quadrant. You can see those big numbers on the floor. Quadrant one worth 1 point, two worth 2 points, so on and so forth. If these kids can clear the entire grid floor, meaning if they can get through all four barbells, they're gonna get their team a total of 10 points to the team total. These boys were moving. We got squat cleans on this ladder today. You got the storm on that screen right now. Now the fire. Here we go, we're going back to the storm. You got their final player in that blue, in that quadrant, and she gets it with ease. The fire having their final quadrant. Can she get this lift? There she is, on the left side of your screen, she gets it. Fire back onto the floor. He's gonna skip the first quadrant, go right to that second one. Sophia, you'll be going to 65. Storm back out there in blue as well. And she gets it. What a squat clean. She's going for that final barbell. You see the storm in blue on the right side, fire in red on the left side of your screen. And she gets it, what a lift. Fire moving into that final quadrant. Oh, she's gonna skip it. So hand it off to her next teammate. Sarah from Team Fire has two successful lifts and she'll pass off to her next teammate. You got the storm. 125 pounds successfully.
Here we go.
Team Fire making easy work of these barbells today. Here comes Team Storm. 125 pounds for Team Storm. She gets it up with ease. That's gonna do it for all of the Storm athletes. We've got two Fire players remaining. Here comes their final player on the grid floor. She's one barbell down. Here comes lift number two. Here comes lift number three. She stands it up, 125 pounds. And that is gonna do it for the ladder race here on Kids Grid. We'll see if we got some time for one more race coming up next.
Trying to get me in trouble?
My must-have food that I have at least once a week is Chipotle with extra everything. White rice with extra rice, double chicken, corn, cheese, and guac. And it's like having two bowls in one.
Ooh, pizza and plátano. I like sushi, but she's always like, let's go for pizza. So we're trying like different pizza places every weekend and try to find like the best spot.
Burritos or tacos, definitely. Like, there's just so much variety with them. You can do it with shrimp, pork, chicken, steak.
Tacos. I can eat tacos every meal.
I eat Karma Cream. It's in Gainesville, and I get a vanilla latte and a macaroon, and it's amazing. And I definitely eat there at least once a week.
Pizza, for sure. Pepperoni. Well done, though. It's gotta be crispy.
It was gonna be pizza, but Willie already said pizza. Burger. Burger and fries. I'll have that once a week.
Mexican food, for sure.
Jimmy John's. A turkey tom.
I've been trying to get stronger, so I'm trying to give these strength specials a little run for their money. So I've been eating a little guilty pleasure, but I've been eating an ice cream for a week now. Once a week. Ben and Jerry's ice cream. Half baked is a good one. And Ice Cream Sammy is a new seasonal one that I really like.
Ooh, once a week.
Ooh. You just want.
Oh, gosh, that's a tough one. I eat a lot of fish. I do. Whatever kind of fish, like salmon, flounder.
I like banana nut muffins and blueberry muffins.
And your reason? You're just like...
I just like muffins. I call them victory muffins. When you have a good week, you make it through, victory muffins.
Oh, man, my go-to snack, I have five of them with me today. I think I only was able to eat one and a half. It would be a whole wheat. Rice cake, peanut butter, raisins.
All of it. But I would definitely say gas station hot dogs are the go-to.
We all possess an innate, savage-like instinct. Whether you want to accept that or not, being relentless, not making excuses, getting after it. There's the easy way and the born primitive way. Failing is okay, because it doesn't matter if you're the lion or the gazelle. When the sun comes up, you better be running. Born primitive, made for the modern savage.
The Fountain of Youth is a standalone product in our collagen line that is fantastic for immune support,
fortifying your hair, skin, nails, your joint health, muscle recovery, and of course, gut health.
We do 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C to plus up the immunity in this. We also include maki berry as a good antioxidant to help you recover.
We also have 10 times the daily recommended value of an essential B vitamin, biotin. Perhaps the best part about the Bubs Fountain of Youth is that the flavor inside this is like a purple taste of magic. When you put all those ingredients together, you've got immune support, you've got great support for your hair, skin and nails, joint health, muscle recovery, and more. And our collagen, as always, is grass-fed, pasture-raised, non-GMO, keto-friendly, paleo diet-friendly, and all-around friendly for you. So come on by and check out the Fountain of Youth.
Feel great, do good. I'm feeling great right now as we're getting into that last race for Kids Grid. But remember, you just saw the Bubs Natural commercial. Make sure you use the code GRID, G-R-I-D, and get 20% off today from our friends at Bubs Naturals. I'm telling you, that MCT oil, put in your coffee every morning. You will not regret it. Once again, getting into the final race for Kids Grid here at Valor Fitness, right outside St. Pete, Florida. Storm in blue, fire in red. Final race right here for these kids. We're going to get each and every single kid out on this grid floor, showing off their talents here on the grid. Storm to make an easy action in the blue. Burpees over that bar. Fire switching their players. Yeah, Coach Paul out there for the fire in the red. For the storm in the blue, you got head coach Jess Crisman, who is also the co-owner slash coach slash player slash captain of the Tampa Bay Grid, which we'll see later on this evening at 7 p.m. take on the Gainesville Wild. Before that, at 5 o'clock, stay tuned. Come on back, vfgl.com/live to see our third match of this quadruple header on this Saturday between the Southwest Florida Sharks as they fight for a playoff spot and the Orlando Aces. Right now, you are watching, tuned in to Kids Grid. You got kids of all ages on this grid floor. We're training the future of the FGL. Back onto that action with the fire as they are pure heat on these box jump overs. She is moving fast. She's going to switch it out. As you get a wide angled view of this grid floor here at Valor Fitness, the Valor Fitness rig, the Valor Fitness facility. A huge shout out to Valor Fitness as a company, as a family. They're pretty much family now. This is our fourth year here at this facility in the Northern Conference. And without Valor Fitness, the entire Grid League as a season would not be possible. So a huge shout out to them as we continue on this Kids Grid. Moving to that big boy box, big girl box, 30 inches. Final element of this race. It all comes down as a fire cross the finish line first. Storm right behind them. That is going to do it for Kids Grid. Fire showing out. Storm showing out. The future of the Florida Grid League showing out. We'll be back at 5 p.m. as the Southwest Florida Sharks take on the Orlando Aces in their final match of the weekend. I'm Alan Duarte. Stay tuned. We'll see you soon.